This is the Ultimaker 2 Plus. It's a wonderful machine. I've got a sweet enclosure from Printed Solid on top, so I can print ABS in Antarctica while I frolic with penguins. And on the front is this incredibly good-looking custom plate by Apyro Design. All of these are available, of course. I will put links in the description. And what's great is this and this are not affiliate links. I will get nothing if you click them. But this is just to showcase something that is very 3D printing 101, and it has to do with jammed and clogged nozzles. I'm going to show you one way to take care of it right here on 3D Printing Nerd. All right, here's the situation. You have your machine. Let's say it's an Ultimaker 2 Plus and it looks just like this. Let's say you're printing some color fab bronze fill. Look at that. Oh, but the extrusions are inconsistent and not full, and you end up with a piece that essentially just crumbles. Color fab bronze fill is an amazing material. It's an expensive material. And when you have a failure like this, you really shouldn't just try again. What you can do is try with a different material just to see if this material isn't good. I happen to have some polyalchemy elixir here in a familiar shape, but the infill looks terrible. Looks terrible. And the piece itself, there's no layer adhesion. And everything is just really, really sad. Once you're at this point and you've tried with a couple different filaments, you have yourself a nozzle jam. And it's not a full jam. It's not a strawberry jam it's not a bacon jalapeno jam. It's just a jam. It's when particulates within the nozzle from previous prints get in the way of the new filament from flowing cleanly through the nozzle and out the tip, where it produces beautiful things. Essentially, what we need to do is clean the nozzle, and we can't shrink ourselves yet that I know of. I don't believe we can. Honey, I shrunk the kids ourselves down to a size that lets us put on a sweet Intel bunny suit and go into the nozzle and just scrape the walls until everything is happy. No, what we need to do is figure out a different way to get the particulates out. And a good way is called a cold pull. Some people have also called it an atomic pull. But when I think of atomic, I think of atomic fireballs and I think of atomic wedgies, neither of which I want currently. So I'm going to continue to refer to it as a cold pull, cold pull, cold pull. For this, you'll need to remove any enclosures or anything that covers the top of your printer. In this case, for the Ultimaker, the printed solid enclosure is over the top. What we want is access to this thing right here. And this, well, this is the head. This is the head. In fact, let me show you. Oh yeah, we're going technical. Look at that. So here is the top of the Ultimaker, and this part right here, those are the fans. There's the hot end, but this is what we want. This is what we want right here, this part right here. So what we're gonna do is take off this little clip and we're gonna set it aside so we don't lose it, because I've lost these before. After you've taken that out, it's best now to actually use the Ultimaker's menu system to remove the filament. So to get the filament out of the way, we're gonna use the Ultimaker menu system. We're gonna go to maintenance. We're gonna go to advanced, and then we're gonna go to heat up nozzle. What we're gonna do is we're gonna set the temperature as high as it'll go, and on the Ultimaker 2 Plus, it's gonna be 260 degrees C. We want it to be hot enough to release the current material that's there, and then we want to cook that nozzle as hot as it'll go for the next step. Easy enough. There we go. Once it's heated up a bunch, it's already hot enough, we can push down on this, and then we should be able to pull this out. Let's see. I'm doing this one-handed. There we go. There we go. So you can see there's that little plug that comes out. I'm pretty sure we got as much of the material out of there as possible. There it is. There's the plug. Right, let's see, right there. Now the material is out and it's available for us to do something with. And so what I like to do is grab myself some nylon. And this is the Tallman nylon. Tallman 645, 3mm round. Do not take this netting off because you'll just have a horrible day. Instead, release some of the nylon there, and then using your flush cutters, cut it off, and then safely tuck the nylon back into the netting so that you can use it at a later date. I usually, I cut the end to at an angle there, makes it easy. So the printer's at 260, easy enough. I'm going to straighten the nylon just a little bit, and then I'm gonna hold my phone here so you can see it. I'm gonna push it down. I'm just gonna push it down. Let's see, get in there. This is why straightening is good. So it goes straight down. Usually there's a Bowden tube there that guides the filament into where it needs to go, but when it's off of a small round, it's not straight. There we go, it's in. And then you push, and then you push. Push it. And there's filament coming out right there. You can actually see it pooling at the bottom. Keep pressure on it. It doesn't have to be like you're pushing your car up a hill. You just need to keep pushing hard. And then while you're doing that, get the temperature down to zero. Just back it all the way down. Takes a lot of power to keep that nozzle at 260, so it won't take too long for it to get back down. But keep the pressure on until you don't see material coming out of the nozzle. But the pressure ensures that the material, as it goes from a molten state to a solid state, it's as impacted into that nozzle inner cavity as possible. This is good because nylon itself is a stronger material, and all of those bits and fragments of old prints and old materials that are in the nozzle, those are going to attach to the nylon. You're putting so much pressure on it, the nylon is going to surround it and just hold on to it. And that's important for the next step. I'm just gonna keep putting pressure on it. And usually for this nylon, usually you're putting pressure until 140, I think, maybe, 135. Okay, if I put pressure on the filament at the top, pushing down, no more comes out of the nozzle. You can see we have a buildup of filament right here, and that's great. Don't pull it out from the nozzle, just leave it, everything is fine. Take a break, go get yourself something tasty to drink. You wanna let this cool down to at least, well, 70C, we'll say 65, 70C. That's a good safe point. We'll be back when it's there. Enjoy your cold beverage. The Ultimaker shows 66C, which is great. It's our next starting point. So with the nylon still in there and a better camera view so you can see things, what you wanna do, heat it right back up. You can go to 200 and some. You don't actually need to go all the way to 260, and here's why. Once you hit the temperature at which the nozzle can release the nylon, everything that's inside that nozzle, or at least a lot of it, hopefully, will be stuck to the nylon and then come out with it. So it's at, there we go. I probably let it heat up too much, but, because I was talking, but look what we got out of there. Look at that. What's great is when you're not talking to a camera and you're paying attention, stuff comes out. So what we can do is clip it off and keep going. And we can see if there's going to be more material in that nozzle. So you turn it up, you shove the nylon in. Once it's at temperature, you push and push and push. You get nylon coming out of the nozzle, and then you cool it down. All right, we got it coming out, we're 260. We're gonna cool it down. Let's see if I can pay attention and not talk to the camera and get a good pull. So when I originally pulled it out and I got this out, it came out really easy. And that's, I mean, it works because you're still at a temperature that will allow the nylon to come out and it'll grab some stuff. But what you want to do is pull it out at an even lower temperature, right as the nylon releases from the inner walls of the nozzle, because then you're getting everything. You should be able to pull up on the nylon and not have it come out until it hits a certain temperature, and then it just pops out. What's kind of fun and interesting is while you're doing this, you'll actually see remnants from inside the nozzle coming out of the nylon extrusion from the nozzle, because even though you want to pull some stuff out, you're still knocking some stuff loose, and you'll see bits and particulates coming out. All right, we're at 164. I can't push anymore. We're going to let it get to 65C, and then we'll be back. All right, we're at 55C, which is great. So let's turn it up and then just hold on to this. I wrapped it around my finger here, and I'm just pulling. There it came out. There it came out. Look at that. Oh, it even got some more stuff. And there it is. You can see that it's got some darkness around it. Some dark, some burn. It's got a little bit of the red filament. It has some particulates in it. You can see that right at the tip, it's actually pointed. And that's because when you put pressure on that nylon, it's going to assume the shape of the inner cavity of the nozzle, which is great. So now what we can do, we can just it shot across the room. Of course it did. Let me find it. Dang it. Laws of physics. There we go. These are the results from today. And then what you can do is take this piece of nylon that you have and set it aside for the next time you need to clean out your nozzle. These are great results. So when I got these though, I'll show you. So here's the two from today right there. This is when I had this mess right here. I did that one, and then I did this one, and then I did this one. So you can tell that they get progressively cleaner, which is great because you're removing more debris, more particulates, more from the inside of your nozzle. This also means that a better nozzle, or a nozzle with less particulates and cruddy stuff with inside of it, allows for a smoother, more consistent filament flow, resulting in beautiful models. Look at that. Oh, you can't see that. There you go. Now you can see it. Now you can see it. This is PolyAlchemy Elixir, and this is the same material that produced this. And it's the same printer that produced this. The only thing that we did different is we cleaned the nozzle using what's called a cold pull and some nylon. So we call it a cold pull because it's not at melting temperature, and we use nylon because nylon is a high temperature material which is strong, and we can pull against it and it won't pop or break. I mean, shoot, technically I guess you could do a cold pull with other materials, but nylon's the best. Now, don't forget to put your printer back together, which I will do. But this was great. I know this is probably remedial for a number of you, but this is probably not remedial for a number of you. And as Tom from Filament Frenzy says, hashtag share, learn, grow. I think that's a great concept. And I think we should always share, we should learn, and help each other grow. I hope that if you ever need to clean out your nozzle, you have some nylon and you have the ability to do a cold pull. Of course, with a Bowden setup, it's super easy. With a direct drive system, it can be a little bit more difficult because you have gears in the way, which you have to take apart. So depending on your printer, you may have to disassemble it a certain way. But if you have a clog and you don't have a spare nozzle to swap in, your printer's either gonna sit there and do nothing, or you're gonna fix it yourself. And my vote is for the latter. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Ring that bell to be notified of when more stuff like this is uploaded to the channel. Big thanks to everybody that supports me in various ways. Beyond all that, don't forget to hug each other more, because I love you guys, as always. High five.